You know, picking up from what you said on the competitive bidding and the fact that the developers have matured on that, I think one of the concerns that at least I understand from a lot of equity players as well, and not only the debt players, is the kind of pricing that is happening in the current market. I mean, not naming one of the developers, I think they did a competitive bid, and 3 days later there was that anti-dumping investigation that occurred, and you know, the assumption of module pricing was 26 or 28 cents, and they're coming currently at 34 to 37 cents. So again, I do you think that we have seen a lot of this competitive bidding happening in the road space, and we sort of see what's happening in that sector as of now. We've seen that in the thermal space. We see what's happening in that sector as of now. So do you think at some level, and this is a question for all panel members, do you think at some level this sort of sunrise sector is also heading down that path, or are we being sensible about it?
In my sense is that people who have been irrational will get weeded out. And there has been some semblance of irrationality in some of the bids. People in the industry would know that there are certain portfolios that are out there for sale now. Because I think initially there was a fair amount of aggression, and but the good thing about that is that that's probably not sustainable, and you know, over a period of time you'll see course correction and sensible players surviving or bidding at levels which make sense. A word of caution there is that, you know, we should, it's maybe not right to look at the unit price and, you know, gauge whether a bid is rational or irrational, because I think you have to look at the capital structure of the player who's bidding for the asset. So for maybe a small Indian IPP who has only recourse to rupee financing, what he can logically bid at would be a number which is higher than maybe someone who is coming with a lot of foreign capital, where both the cost of equity and debt, even post hedging, is far lower than what players in India get. So it's, you know, sometimes we get lost in just a number, but it's maybe we have to go a level beyond. And I think some of the Indian players have erred in that sense in trying to match some of those foreign players in terms of the unit pricing, rather than looking at their own financial models and seeing what their cost of capital is, what is a reasonable equity return. And I think those players are either suffering or will suffer in due course.
Yeah, so a couple of things are happening here. I think one, definitely from the developer side, that there is a lowering of the return expectations which has happened. That is for sure. Because if we look at the current bids which have come, whether in solar or wind, I mean, given the kind of price, and understandably those are good wind sites and with highly efficient wind turbines which are coming with hub heights of 120 meters and all. So that is also playing. So that is basically increasing the viability so they can sustain that bids. But apart from that also, there is some degree of adjustment in their return expectations which has happened. I'm talking about the competitive bids. Now, the one thing which for me is slightly significant here is that, well, again, I will be harping upon the fact that the contract or the trust that you have on the government. Now, there's a big gap between what the central government through NTPC or SECI are trying to do, the kind of trust that they are building up, and what actually comes on ground, because it is the state discoms who are the real off-takers. So example, case in point is the Kadapa solar park which has come up. Now NTPC was the central counterparty, and now it was supposed to, so the winning bid was 3.15, which again, as I said, which is a leap up from the 2.44 which has come up. So the solar at least has matured. It has priced in the fact that the module prices have gone up and all that stuff. But when it comes to you know, the signing of the PPAs, now the signing of the PPAs are getting sort of postponed. Now, why is it happening? Despite the fact that the counterparty is NTPC, they are not able to push through because the Andhra DISCOMs are the final off-takers. So, I mean, we have not heard the last on this. But what the case in point is that you are not able to put your trust in the central entity also because of the fact that at the end of the day, you know, the weakest link is still the, you know, the state utilities. So that is the kind of, you know, kind of uncertainty which is there.
See, now lower pricing, definitely it is a good, and from national perspective it is very nice. And now, as far as I think DISCOM concern, DISCOM should be happy that they are getting much better pricing as compared to the conventional energy, means from thermal, that is I think 3 rupees 30 paise or something it comes around, average costing. So as long as it is a lesser than that, then definitely for DISCOM, so they should be, but maybe other technical issues, maybe preventing them to purchase actually, but definitely this, so even at this 1000 megawatt, if you take the this wind, SECI has done it, and different various state has taken it up, and they are very happy. If you see that either Bihar or UP, they have, I think, each one has taken some portion of it. So definitely they are very happy. And as far as the this capital structuring or the costing, project cost, that may be definitely now how they have done it. So earlier the price per megawatt was very high. Now definitely that would have come down. And the factors actually that since from those projects we have not received anything so far, so that really I can't actually comment on it, that what factor they have taken into account. So that considering those factors and with the, this lower tariff, but definitely as far as the this new dimension may be added also, and now definitely now the RPO obligations also, now if you see RPO obligation has no meaning now, that more and more states can go and for this renewable energy based in power, and that situation definitely good for the country, that something. And now if we see now the government of India or India has given the international commitment that by 2030 we have to reduce carbon emission, as well as we have to actually contribute 40% from the renewables. So in that perspective, definitely we will be able to achieve the target, the whatever the goal we have made or making. So in that way, though, then I think we should be all happy that this bid price, through this bidding, reverse bidding method, this pricing is coming down. Now definitely some now manufacturers may be hit badly because of this. So now I don't know how actually they have earned, but as far as the loan debt concerned, see now they can now a lot of foreign funds at lower pricing is available, like masala bond, this IREDA has picked up at 7.125%, and that is very much lower than the what are actually average cost at present is coming. So really I see this from national perspective point of view, definitely this lower pricing is better. And now of course now solar pricing from 2.44, now it has gone up again. So it all depends upon now if it stabilize around this, and see depending upon the price of modules and other balance of systems, if it is okay, so little variation, that is also okay.
Abhilakh pointed out that foreign financing is essential. In my view, it's, well, it's extremely essential for this sector to achieve the targets that have been set up. And in my view, it can't be done without heavy foreign investment, both in the equity and debt space. And I just sort of want to ask you, Gaurav, about the recent deals that, I mean, the SBI deal of 2317 odd crores was big. And I think Cleantech was one of the beneficiaries as well, amongst other players. So when you're sort of giving funds in India, what is the long-term vision vis-a-vis the Indian space from a World Bank perspective?
Continue to support the government of India's initiative to go renewable. It answers many question dependence on oil, GHG emissions, to which we as an organization have committed to support. Our investments currently are at about 20% of our investments are climate friendly. Our corporate target is to take it to 28%. So internally we have that thrust. We believe that as India develops more and more green sources of energy, we will find players like IREDA and like SBI who will be great partners. And the actual SBI deal size is $625 million. So the total loan amount of which this commitment happened is $625 million just to do rooftops, probably $80 million or so with IREDA. So that is the kind of money that the government of India is already seeking of us. And we see that as a very big positive, both for India to achieve its own NDC target, which Mr. Singh just pointed out is something that we need to do by 2030 as a commitment as a country, right? And I now speak as an Indian citizen that, okay, in whatever our combined wisdom is in this room and elsewhere, we've said, okay, we're going to do 40% renewable. So on that side, the bank is very happy because it also helps us as an organization to show that from the dirty coal with which people think it was dirty, right? So especially Indian coal, which had a lot of ash, which had problems like what we have in Delhi on air quality, we are moving to cleaner sources of fuel. So for us, institutionally, it is a very nice way of working that we have strong partners like SBI going out and finding strong people. We don't know how many of them, what Alpit was asking, how many of them will be individual power producers versus how many of them will be the grassims of SBI's 100-year relationship. I do not know the split at this moment, but the idea is eventually to make $625 million worth of solar panels stand up on roofs, whether they are of SBI or Gaurav Joshi's housetop. Does not matter, as long as that energy gets used up and substitutes for energy that comes out of coal, right? Or any other polluting source, diesel or whatever people use. In some places, we still use diesel. No, just outside in Gurgaon, a lot of people use diesel to get homes powered. So as long as that substitution happens, the bank is very happy. We stand ready to increase loan size. We also have concessional financing under the Clean Technology Fund. And now India also has, in addition to us, access to the Green Climate Finance, where you can get a lot of money. And there may be more money than we can handle at this moment until capacity to install becomes higher. That may be a constraint that we may also face. But currently we are in a sweet spot. The disbursement is high. Our folks are happy. And we are seeing that people are doing that responsibly. As an environmental specialist, I would be more concerned with what would happen over the life of the project. What would happen when we had a lot of solar rooftops going in? What would that do to the environment? And handling those issues with the government is something that the bank looks forward to. It has been in dialogue on items of mutual interest. Sometimes our interests and the government of India's interests are slightly different, but when they are common, we have tried to be good partners, and we look forward to doing that over time. For us, currently it is looking like we will disburse at SBI for the short answer. If Mr. Singh does it well, then we will also disburse with IREDA very soon.
Both these disbursements are for the rooftop space?
No. What IREDA is going to do is it is going to help the solar parks develop their common infrastructure. On SBI, we are doing rooftops only, but those rooftops may not be necessarily residential rooftops. They could be industrial. So the grassims of the world may be beneficiaries of those. Or if there are real rescos, then they may aggregate. And that we have left to SBI's discretion, because they know about the individual borrower. Just as we know more about institutional borrowers like countries, sovereigns, SBI knows far more about individual borrowers than we could ever and our overheads would not permit individual transactions. So we leave those criteria to SBI, but our idea is to help them develop $625 million worth of solar rooftops. So that is where it stands.
And would you also be looking or open to the idea of funding these institutions for funding IPP projects?
We haven't laid down constraints on them. For instance, what IREDA is doing is looking at those solar parks which are in JV with SECI, I think, in each of the states, and we are funding those SPVs. So they could be IPPs, but that is a decision that IREDA needs to take once it looks at the profile of the borrower and once SBI looks at the profile of the borrower. So SBI may look at IPPs which are smaller, maybe IREDA also, maybe Mr. Singh would like to take it up from there.
Actually, the solar infrastructure funding, that is not the issue, because this is actually state government is developing, not state government, joint venture of SECI and the state government. So that for MP, in fact, even if without this, that consideration is going on for this funding. But they have, meanwhile, they have requested, so we have actually already sanctioned this guarantee scheme. So in case DISCOM is not able to pay, then they will draw the money from us and will pay to the developers. That we have already, and now, in fact, against this loan, why they are actually waiting or hesitating, because of this Government of India fee concession. So, but meanwhile, what they have requested again, even while I was coming, then they were talking, that loan against that, whatever the loan to be availed from under this IFC, through IFC, this World Bank. So against that, we can consider to give them loan for time being, till this issue is resolved. So that is also going on. And now, while we have gone to our board, we have taken another approval that similar projects, if comes, then we will do in other states also. Because here, the one model we have developed already, and that model now perfectly okay. And we sat together with Manu Srivastava, Sav, and his team, and then our team, then we have make some good program for that. So, and because the state government is involved, state government is giving guarantee, so there is not much issue actually on secret side. Yes. Now, one comment on this rooftop scheme. See, now World Bank has given to SBI. Similarly, KfW has given to us, and PNB also has signed the agreement with the ADB. And then NDB, I think it is with Canara Bank. That is going on. Now, as I think you raised the individual financing, actually, see, now the problem is not the financing. If you see 1 kilowatt or 2 kilowatt requirement, how much money? Why actually even a loan is required for that few thousands rupees? So I have been suggesting that actually the some developer for that market, developers should come forward and they should develop the market for this 1 kilowatt or 2 kilowatt systems. That is actually requirement of smaller towns and all that. I don't think beyond that. And even then, 5 kilowatt, 10 kilowatt, I think this RBI has already issued the instructions that this loan can be availed at par with the housing loan. And that actually, if any individual want, then they can go very well, but definitely there is some issues. But even if I think all of us or majority of us have availed the loan from the one bank or other bank, so that actually, if you want to some few lakh rupees, they will also, they don't mind. Even if keep on so many phone calls keep on coming, and that is not the issue. If individual want to go and avail the loan, even they can avail few lakhs on credit card or personal loans, that should not be a problem. But actually, this mark, definitely there is issues in solar rooftop, because we have announced the scheme in July 15, and we are also facing a problem, because now every time if any new customer comes or new then the problems comes different kind of, like if building this, let's say this Radisson Hotel is here, they have decided that they want to go for a rooftop. They don't have control from this side or that side. So suddenly somebody has actually, or never, he has raised the bigger than this, higher than this building. Then there, of course, in this area, it may not be allowed because of the airport. But elsewhere, if you see, anyone, so in that actually, if you see rooftop, these institutions are very safe because now institutions most likely for longer period will not go for the higher buildings if once infrastructure is there. Then maybe industrial also, there should not be a problem. But definitely for individuals, then the market has to be developed in a very different way. And probably, I don't think manufacturers are also so too keen to actually develop that sort of a market to targeting individual. Maybe because the volume is very less. So even for 100 megawatt, they have to find out so many, how many customers, I think lakhs of customers, they have to find it out. So that is, whereas they can do 100 megawatt somewhere else in any of the state. So at least perhaps that is actually preventing this solar rooftop. But of course, this utilities also, discoms are also, they are having a problem. I think last month we had a meeting with this with all three discoms, and they were raising their own issues, and they were asking. So then I was suggesting them, make some scheme like that. You give a guarantee that instead of setting up this power generated, what you do, you continue to charge them whatever the money is actually supposed to be paid to the customer. Yeah, you pay, put in the account so that this repayment should not be. So, but I don't think any discount. Then they have come immediately that, oh, discounts are not allowed to actually for generation. That Electricity Act perhaps preventing that discom cannot go for generation. So that will be deemed generation if they go for it. So there are actually different issues, but definitely this solar rooftop scheme is a very nice. And if you see the long-term perspective, this, you know, bigger size of project, definitely at one end when we will be comfortable with our energy situation, then it will go slow down or will stabilize or some replacement and that type of. But rooftop, I don't think next 50 years or until unless some other more efficient equipment or some other sources are there. So rooftop will continue for much longer period, and should not be a problem. And see now, 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, or even a 5 kilowatt, up to 5 kilowatt, there should not be any problem. Actually, even this consumer items, loans are available easily from the Bajaj Finance, then Future Finance, and so many. And probably this also can be added. But that market has to be developed by these manufacturers or developers. Then only it can happen.